Good morning, students. Today we are going to discuss electromagnetic fundamentals. So far we have covered few points in previous lectures, but today we are going to take a review of all those points. Okay, so one by one we will cover the various points up till now covered in unit number 1. For example, in the previous lectures we discussed coordinate systems, scalars and vectors, then product of vectors, then gradient, divergence and curl. So one by one we will take a review of all of this. First of all, what exactly electromagnetics is? Electromagnetics is a branch of physics. Hope you can find my arrow here. It is a branch of physics or electrical engineering in which electric and magnetic phenomena are studied. EM principles finds applications in various disciplines, various areas such as in microwave area, then antennas, electrical machines, satellite communications, nuclear research, fiber optics, electromagnetic interference, compatibility, electromechanical energy conversion, radar. All these areas requires the fundamentals of electromagnetics. Electromagnetics means what? It is a branch of physics in which the concepts of electric field, magnetic field and concerned phenomena are studied. EM power in the form of short waves are used to hit deep tissues and to stimulate certain physiological responses. This is also one possible application. Dielectric heating equipment uses short waves to join or seal thin sheet of plastic material. So there also electromagnetic is used to join the plastic materials. EM energy offers many new exciting possibilities in agriculture as well. For example, to change the vegetable taste by reducing acidity. That means vegetable taste can be changed by reducing the acidity with the help of electromagnetic fundamentals. EM devices, there are so many EM devices in the market or in day-to-day life we use. Which are those EM devices? Transformers are there, electric relays in day-to-day life we observe, radio is there, television we use in day-to-day life, then electric motors we require in our day-to-day life. Transmission lines, waveguides and antennas, all these are very usual terms which we find in our day-to-day life. All they uses the concepts of electromagnetic. So that's why electromagnetic is a very interesting and important subject, and that is why it is kept in your syllabus. Now whenever we deal with electromagnetics, obviously electromagnetic signal goes from one point to the other. So what frequency is used for the communication? That is a point of interest. That means this question is very important. So there is a broad range of frequencies utilized for electromagnetic transmissions, electromagnetic waves transmission. The range of frequencies may start from 10 raised to 4 hertz to 10 raised to 4. This is frequency in hertz. So 10 raised to 4 to 10 raised to 20 hertz. So you can imagine the range, broad range of frequencies of electromagnetic spectrum. Spectrum means range of frequencies over which the electromagnetic fundamentals are used or electromagnetic waves can propagate from one point to the other. This particular rho is for the dimensions of wavelength. For example, if your wave uses 10 raised to 4, the frequency range of the order of 10 raised to 4, then the wavelength of the electromagnetic signal is, it could be as large as a building. Here one scenario is shown. Here the electromagnetic signal wavelength is very large, but as you go on this side, on the right side, the wavelength goes on decreasing. Wavelength means what? The distance covered by the wave to complete one cycle. So as you increase this frequency range, frequency of propagation, then automatically the wavelength of the signal goes on decreasing, and it at the end it could be as small as your nucleus of an atom. Okay, this way there is a indirect relation. It is indirectly proportional. That means wavelength is indirectly proportional with frequency in case of electromagnetic spectrum. So if your frequency range is in this range, then such a range is called as radio frequency signal. If your frequency range is in 10 raised to 8 to 10 raised to 12, then this frequency range is called as microwave frequency range or microwave domain. All the equipments, electronic or electrical equipment, those are working in this particular frequency domain, then all these are nothing but microwave elements or microwave components or microwave system. If your frequency of communication for the your system is in between 10 raised to 12 to 10 raised to 15, then the such a corresponding system is said to be based on infrared or visible. That means those system uses the infrared portion of electromagnetic spectrum, visible portion of electromagnetic spectrum. So which portions are there in this electromagnetic spectrum? Electromagnetic spectrum starts from this point and then ends at this particular point. So 10 raised to 4 to 10 raised to 20. So in this particular electromagnetic spectrum, it is divided into these types or these areas. The first part is called as radio frequency, then microwave, then infrared spectrum, then invisible, ultraviolet, X-ray and gamma. So this particular diagram gives you an idea of what frequencies are utilized for propagation of electromagnetic signal. How the electromagnetic signal propagates from one point to the other? For example, there is some transmitter here, transmitting antenna, and suppose there is a receiving antenna like here. So whatever transmitting antenna transmit, it goes through the aerial route towards the receiver. And as we know that generally this type of communication is wireless communication, and the wave is nothing but an electromagnetic wave. Okay, that means the wave consists of E part electric field plus magnetic field, and both constitute an electromagnetic wave or electromagnetic signal, electromagnetic wave or electromagnetic signal. So electromagnetic signal contains electric field as well as magnetic field. So electric field and magnetic field generally are perpendicular to each other. Whenever electromagnetic signal flows from one point to the other, from this point to the receiver point, then in this particular wave both the components are present and both components are perpendicular to each other, and the direction of propagation is perpendicular to both. So here the diagram is shown. For example, if the electric field is in top direction, upward direction, and suppose the magnetic field is in this direction, then the direction of propagation of wave is always perpendicular to both. Okay, not necessarily that electric field is always in the upward direction. Electric field could be in this direction. Okay, magnetic field could be in this direction, no problem. Then if it is so, then direction of electromagnetic wave propagation is in upward direction. So how exactly this electromagnetic signal look like? Although it cannot be observed through our naked eyes, but the analogy which is popular across the world in order to explain the electromagnetic wave is like this. For example, this is your electric field. Red line indicates electric field, and this blue line indicates magnetic field. Both are, you can observe, they are 90 degree apart from each other. They are perpendicular to each other, while the direction of propagation is perpendicular to both. So this is the way the electromagnetic signal gets transmitted from transmitter to receiver through a medium. Which is this medium? at this point this medium is free space. Okay, as there is no physical medium in between transmitter and receiver, that means it is a wireless communication. And in case of wireless communication, electromagnetic signals are used. The fundamentals of fundamentals which are used during this communications are electromagnetic fundamentals. And the medium here in this case is a free space. Sometimes the medium in between transmitter and receiver may be different, but in most of the cases in this particular subject, whenever we discuss this medium, that medium generally we assume to be a free space. Okay, free space. Now we will discuss today another important topic, that is unit vector. Now what exactly unit vector is? Suppose this is my any vector A bar. Sometimes I will show this vector as simply by A, sometimes I show this vector as A bar. Both are one and the same thing. So this A bar vector is having some magnitude. How much is the magnitude? This much is the magnitude. So hope you will understand. So this is the magnitude. Magnitude is from this to this. This is magnitude. And what is the direction? Direction is this. Okay. So A bar is always equal to some magnitude and some direction. Okay. So for example, A bar is having a magnitude A. So how you can find out A, and what is the concept of unit vector? So any vector always have some unit vector along it. This unit vector is shown along same direction. This is your unit vector A. It is very difficult here to write on this with the help of this pen, but hope you will understand this. So what I mean to explain, if you are having any vector like this, for example A bar or A, this vector always have a unit vector along this direction. Unit vector is having a unit magnitude. What is the magnitude of A bar? A bar magnitude starts from this point and ends here. So this much length is nothing but the magnitude of this A bar. But what is the magnitude of unit vector of A bar? Unit vector of A bar is shown like this. Unit vector of A bar, and it is denoted in this fashion, small a, and this vector, what is this total vector? A. Okay, so this A is nothing but a unit vector of this A bar. Sometimes this unit vector is also shown in this fashion, A cap. A cap is nothing but a unit vector of A bar. Okay, what exactly this unit vector is? Unit vector is nothing but a vector which is along the same vector direction, but its magnitude is 1. Its magnitude is 1. Okay, how would you calculate the unit vector? It's very simple. You divide the vector by its magnitude. Divide the vector by its magnitude. So how you will show the magnitude? Sometimes the magnitude is shown like this, simply by A, and the unit vector is your A cap. Okay, so the A bar is equal to A into A cap. So this part is nothing but magnitude of this A bar, and this is unit vector of this A bar. So A bar can be represented with the help of magnitude as well as direction. So magnitude and unit vector is sufficient to express any vector A bar. So A bar, this magnitude, how would you find out this unit vector? Unit vector can be obtained by dividing the vector A bar by its magnitude. So if you shift A bar, this magnitude on this side, dividing A bar by this A, you will get A cap. Okay, And how will you find out the magnitude of A bar? For example, your point A is somewhere here. Suppose this is your point, suppose this is your point P, and whose coordinates are 3, 2 and 2. 3, 2, 2. So how will you find out the, what are the x, y, z coordinates then? X is equal to 3, y equal to 2 and z equal to 2. So x, what is the x component of this, suppose this is A bar, like this. The coordinates of this particular point A, this is origin obviously. The point coordinates of this point A is 3, 2, 2, then how will you denote this A bar? A bar will be denoted by 3 AX cap plus 2 AY cap plus 2 AZ cap, like this. Here you can find here. A vector A bar in Cartesian coordinates may be represented in this fashion. Then if it is so, then magnitude can be found out in this fashion. The magnitude of A bar is equal to square root of AX cap plus AY cap plus AZ cap. Suppose your vector is something like this. Suppose your vector is A bar is equal to 3 AX cap plus 2 AY cap plus 3 AZ cap. It is very difficult to write with the help of this pen on the screen, but hope you can you will be comfortable with this, but because there is no another option to write this in front of me. So if A bar is equal to 3 AX cap plus 2 AY cap plus 3 AZ cap, then magnitude of A bar can be found out in this fashion. A bar is equal, magnitude of A bar is equal to, then the magnitude is sometimes also written in this fashion, mod of A bar is equal to square root of, what is the AX component of this A bar? What is the component of A bar in X direction? The component of A bar in X direction is 3. What is the component of A bar in Y direction? It is 2. What is the component of A bar in Z direction? It is 3. That means AX is 3, AY is 2, and this AZ is 3. So how will you find out the magnitude of this A bar then? Square, take a square of this AX, it is 9 then. Square of 2 is 4, and square of 3 is 9. So 9 plus 9, it is 18. 18 plus 4, it is 22. So magnitude of this A bar is square root 22. Then how will you find out the, how would you find out the unit vector of this A bar? So unit vector of this A bar is written like this, AA or AA cap. So AA cap is equal to divide the vector, divide this total vector by its magnitude. So what is the total vector in this example? 3 AX cap plus 2 AY cap plus 3 AZ cap divided by its magnitude. What is the magnitude now? Square root 22. So in this fashion, unit vector can be obtained. A magnitude can be obtained with the help of this formula. Okay. So this is example of A bar. You can take any vector, for example B bar or C bar or D bar, any vector. For any vector you can find out its magnitude as well as its unit vector. Every vector always have its unit vector. Okay, so unit vector means what? Unit vector is nothing but a vector of unit magnitude which is along the same direction as that of the given vector. Okay, for example A bar is like this, for example, then unit vector of A bar is written in this fashion, AA cap, and it is shown in this manner. Okay, that means unit vector of A bar is also in the direction of A bar, but its magnitude is 1. So this you have to remember always. So in this electromagnetic subject, we deals with many vectors, many vector fields. So each time we require to calculate the magnitude of those vectors as well as unit vectors of those vectors. For example, in electrostatics, we will deal with E bar, D bar, F bar, etc. And many times we need to find out the unit vector of E bar, D bar and F bar. Similarly, we deal with Cartesian coordinate system, cylindrical coordinate system, spherical coordinate system in this particular subject. And for these three systems, we always have three unit vectors of each. So that we will cover in the next slides to come. Hope you understood the concept of unit vector. Now what exactly the position vector concept is? Position vector means, for example, with this diagram you can understand. For example, your point P is given in the space in this fashion, whose coordinates are 3, 4 and 5. That means x coordinate is 3, y is 4 and z is 5. So what is the position vector of point P? Position vector of point P is nothing but it is a vector or radius vector which starts from origin to given point. It is nothing but a directed distance from origin to P, origin to given point. So what is position vector of a point? Position vector of a point is nothing but a distance vector or radius vector directed from origin to the given point is nothing called, it is nothing but position vector of that point. So how will you write down OP bar? How will you write down this distance vector or position vector of point P? Simply by, first of all, you write down small r and then write down the name of that point, point P. So RP is nothing but a position vector of point P. Okay, so how will you find out the RP bar? As this vector starts from origin always, position vector always starts from origin point O. So that's why position vector you can straight away write down in this fashion. You write down x component here, y component here and z component here. So here the position vector of point P is RP bar is equal to, sometimes somebody may write RP bar in this fashion or somebody may write only RP. So RP is equal to 3 ax cap, 4 ay cap plus 5 az cap. Again I repeat, sometimes I will pronounce it as ax, ay, az. Sometimes I may pronounce it as ax cap, ay cap and az cap. Both are one and the same thing. This you have to remember always. So position vector concept you understood. Now what exactly the concept of distance vector? For example, in this particular diagram, point P is given and point Q is given. So for example, suppose point Q is given like this, whose coordinates are, for example, 1, 1 and 1. Suppose the coordinates of point Q are 1, 1, 1. So what is, how would you show the position vector of point Q? Position vector of point Q you can show in this fashion. And how will you write this position vector? R Q. So how will you, what will be the position vector of point Q in this case? If it is the, if the coordinates are 1, 1 and 1, then 1 ax cap plus 1 ay cap plus 1 az cap will be the position vector of R Q. Now what exactly the distance vector is? If the two points P and Q are given with these coordinates x1, y1, z1, x2, y2, z2, then the distance vector between these two can be written in this fashion, RQ minus RP, second vector minus first vector. Second point, which is the second point here? Q. First point is P. So second point position vector minus first point position vector. So in this fashion you can find out the distance vector between two points. So in this case distance vector will be 3 minus 1 ax cap plus 4 minus 1 ay cap plus 5 minus 1 az cap will be the distance vector between point P and Q. One problem we will cover now in this particular lecture, one problem on vector, and then we will stop. For example, the problem is given in this fashion. Suppose A is equal to 10ax minus 4ay plus 6az and B is equal to 2ax plus ay. Then find the component of A bar along y direction. So what is the component of A bar or A along x direction? 10. Along y direction it is 4. Along z direction it is. Along z direction the component of A is 6. Okay, so first part is very simple. Second is, what is the magnitude of 3a minus b? So 3a minus b, how will you find out the magnitude? We don't want vector, we want magnitude. So how will you find out the magnitude of 3a minus b? So first of all, you write down in this fashion, 3 in bracket, the coordinates of point A, 10 minus 4, 6. Coordinates of point A are 10 minus 4, 6 minus B coordinates are 2, 1 and there is no Z component. There is no Z component here given in B bar. That's why it is 0. So multiply this 3 into this bracket, you will get this minus this, you will get this. So this will be the magnitude of 3A minus 2B. Hence, but this is not a magnitude, this is the coordinates. These are the coordinates of 3a minus b vector. This is a vector. This is one vector. Why? Because a was a vector, 3a will be a vector, b will be a vector, one vector minus second vector, this would also be a vector. So how will you find out the magnitude of this then? Magnitude, again the same formula. Square root x component square plus y component square plus z component square. So what is the x component here? 28 square minus 13 square plus 18 square. This will be the magnitude of vector 3a minus b. What is the third part? Third part is asked is a unit vector you want along a plus 2b. So what is asked? Find out the unit vector along this vector a plus 2b. So a is a vector, b is also vector, 2b is also vector. Addition of two vector is also vector. So for example, suppose this vector is like this, a plus 2b. This vector is like this. So what is the unit vector of this vector? Unit vector is a vector along the same direction but with magnitude 1. So what is asked? Find out the unit vector with this, for this particular vector. So what is the formula of finding out the unit vector? Formula of finding out the unit vector is very simple. What is that formula? Divide the vector divide the vector by its magnitude. So what is the vector given in this problem? The vector given, vector is not given a plus 2b, but we have to find out the a plus 2b in this fashion. So let us consider c is equal to a plus 2b. What are the a coordinates? 10 minus 4, 6 plus b coordinates 2, 1 multiply by 2, it will be 4, 2, 0. Adding these two, you will get this. So c vector will be like this. C vector would have coordinates 14 minus 2, 6. That means c bar is equal to 14ax cap minus 2ay cap, 14ax cap minus 2ay cap plus 6az cap will be nothing but c bar or simply c. Okay, so unit vector along c bar, how will you find out? Divide the vector by its magnitude. Divide the vector by its magnitude. What is the vector? It is 14 minus 2, 6, or you simply you can write down here. In place of this, you can also write down in this fashion, 14ax cap minus 2ay cap plus 6az cap divided by its magnitude. Okay. So in this fashion, you will get the unit vector AC, that means vector along C vector, unit vector along C bar or C. It may be written in this fashion, AC cap, no problem. As it is a unit vector, sometimes some books show it by cap symbol. So hope you understood this problem. Points P and Q are second problem. Points P, Q are located at these coordinates. Calculate the position vector of P. How will you calculate the position of vector of P? Simply write down 0 ax cap, 2 ay cap, 4 az cap. So this will be the position vector of point P. It is denoted by R P. Position vector of Q will be denoted by R Q. What will be the position vector of point Q? -3 ax cap plus 1 ay cap plus 5 az cap. So position vector of P is very simple to obtain. Distance vector of from P to Q. How will you obtain this distance vector? It is very simple. Here we in the last few slides we have found out the distance vector. Divide the this subtract the second position vector by the first position vector. Okay, that means second point coordinates minus first point coordinates. So here you can find which are the second point coordinates. RPQ, distance vector RPQ will be equal to RQ minus RP is equal to second point coordinates are -3, 1, 5 and first point coordinates are 0, 2, 4. Subtracting these two you will get this. So RPQ will be then -3 ax cap, then -1 ay cap plus 1 az cap. So this is the answer. Distance between P and Q. How will you find out distance between P and Q? Once you obtain this distance vector, then find out the magnitude of this. Magnitude of this vector is nothing but distance between point P and Q. So square root of 3 square, 1 square, 1 square is this. So this is the distance between point P and Q. A vector parallel to PQ with magnitude 10. So hope you understood the fundamentals of electromagnetic signal, then concept of unit vectors, some small problems on unit vectors. In the next lecture we will discuss vector multiplication and means dot product and cross product. Thank you.